The damage caused by Orochimaru's plot to destroy the Hidden Leaf was catastrophic. To recover from this tremendous upheaval, the village was in need of a new leader. That honor fell to the Toad Sage Jiraiya, who was also a legendary Sannin like Orochimaru. Although Jiraiya had been asked to become the next Hokage, he embarked on a journey to find another suitable candidate. Naruto accompanied him on that journey. At that same time, the village received an unexpected visitor. It was Itachi Uchiha, rogue ninja of the Hidden Leaf and member of the organization known as the Akatsuki. Itachi was Sasuke's older brother, as well as his hated enemy. 5 years earlier, Itachi had slaughtered every member of the village's prestigious Uchiha clan in a single night, save Sasuke. Learning of Itachi's visit, Sasuke left in quick pursuit and came upon him just as he was trying to capture Naruto.
Long time no see, Sasuke.
Itachi Uchiha, you're the one person I'll never forgive! Itachi Uchiha! Get ready to die!
You're not strong enough.
Sasuke fought valiantly, but the gap in their abilities was insurmountable, and he fell victim to Itachi's genjutsu, known as Tsukuyomi. Your hate isn't strong enough. And with those words, Itachi departed, but not before also getting the best of Jiraiya, who had rushed to Naruto and Sasuke's defense. As they trained, they continued their journey to find a worthy individual. Jiraiya had set his sights on Tsunade, a preeminent medical ninja and fellow member of the legendary Sannin. Just then, Orochimaru and his devoted assistant, Kabuto Yakushi, approached Tsunade to request her assistance with healing Orochimaru's sealed arms. They tried to tempt her with a promise to resurrect her loved ones. When such enticements proved ineffective, Kabuto wounded Tsunade. It was there that Naruto and Jiraiya intervened. Naruto faced off with Kabuto using Rasengan, a new ninjutsu he had learned during his training with Jiraiya.
Your free reign ends here!
Are you sure a wimp like you can fight me? Get in my way and I won't go easy on you.
Shadow Clone Jutsu!
Kids should act like kids and run away!
Enough! Stop it! Leave me! Go away!
Don't worry about me. Until I become Hokage, there's no way I'll die!
Moved by the sight of such passion, Tsunade found the will to fight once more. Severely wounded in the battle between all three legendary Sannin, Orochimaru and Kabuto retreated. With Tsunade assuming the role of the fifth Hokage, the Hidden Leaf embarked on a fresh start, only for a new problem to soon emerge. Lured by an invitation from Orochimaru's underlings known as the Sound Five, Sasuke departed the village. Together with the shinobi he had competed against in the Chunin exam, Naruto set off on a mission to recover Sasuke. After a grueling mission in which his teammates fell one by one, at long last, Naruto reached the last of the Sound Five. Orochimaru had placed a curse mark on Kimimaro and viewed him as a potential new vessel. However, he fell out of favor after contracting a terminal illness. Even still, Kimimaro idolized his master so much that he was willing to lay down his life in battle to help procure Sasuke.
I'll never let you take Sasuke! Ever!
I'll finish you off quickly.
Just then, Sasuke exploded out of a coffin being transported by the Five in a very strange state. While perplexed, Naruto was glad to see Sasuke safe. But Sasuke simply ran away, ignoring Naruto. With Naruto under furious assault, Rock Lee rushed in to save him.
Bushibro, how did you...
Do not worry, Naruto. Go get Sasuke. I will defeat him. I promise. Hey, what are you doing? Go now!
Right, he's all yours!
With Lee taking over for him, Naruto took off after Sasuke. And so, he arrived at the final valley, where the two shinobi who founded the Hidden Leaf had once engaged in battle. There, Naruto confronted Sasuke. To save his great friend and rival, Naruto tried to prevent Sasuke's escape. To obtain the power to defeat Itachi, Sasuke had presented himself to Orochimaru, knowing that he would be used as a vessel. While Naruto came to help his friend, Sasuke was abandoning his. Holding fast to their convictions, the two extremes began their decisive clash in the final valley.
Why, Sasuke, why? How could it have come to this? I don't understand!
I have my own path to follow. No one has the right to tell me what path I should be on. Why would you go this far for me?
I finally feel connected to someone! And that's why I have to stop you!
Naruto unleashed the nine-tailed fox's chakra in the hopes of stopping his friend, while Sasuke activated his curse mark and awakened its second state.
Let's just end this. And all our other battles up to now. Naruto!
Sasuke!
In a clash demanding all of their might, Rasengan dueled with Chidori. The moment had finally arrived to conclude their desperate struggle. But Naruto's feelings didn't reach Sasuke. And and he collapsed to the ground in front of him, unconscious. But Sasuke chose not to take Naruto's life. He left in search of a different, superior power to that of his brothers. And so, the mission to recover Sasuke ended in bitter failure. The struggle between two friends, walking two different paths, continued on like a river without end. Two and a half years passed from the time Sasuke left the Hidden Leaf. Naruto grew stronger as Jiraiya's pupil, and Sakura studied medical ninjutsu under Tsunade. Now full-fledged ninja, they joined forces with Kakashi, their former captain. Kakashi announced that he would test their abilities by having them undergo the same trials as in the past.
Well, same rules as 3 years ago. Just take these bells from me. Of course, if you don't come at me aggressively, you'll never get the bells.
We'll show Kakashi-sensei exactly what we're made of.
Yep. We'll show him what the training did.
Now then, let's begin.
Yeah!
Yes!
I guess I'll have to be tougher on you. You're doing well. But can you do it again? I I didn't think you'd manage to take the bells.
Sakura.
You too!
All right! Maybe I'm even stronger than you now, Kakashi.
Stop acting so conceited.
Anyway, you both passed the test, and you'll be going on the next mission with me.
They thereby demonstrated to Kakashi that they were no longer students, but rather qualified shinobi worthy of trust. And with that, Team Kakashi was formed. Just then, Naruto suddenly received some unexpected news. Gaara, who once competed ruthlessly at the Chunin exam and now served as the Kazekage, had been abducted by a member of the Akatsuki. The Akatsuki had a plan to extract the tailed beasts from the Jinchuriki, such as Naruto and Gaara, to use them for their own nefarious purposes. To rescue Gaara, Naruto and his friends attacked an Akatsuki hideout. There, Naruto found Deidara, who had abducted Gaara, along with Gaara's lifeless body, which had had Shikaku ripped from it. Naruto chased after Deidara, and they engaged in battle in the forest. Understanding the agony Gaara must have endured, Naruto erupted in a violent rage against the barbaric Akatsuki.
Give me back Gaara!
Bring it if you can.
You. I can never forgive you!
With the help of friends, he drove Deidara off and recovered Gaara's body. There was no one, however, who could bring him back from death.
Why Gaara? Why is it always him?
Calm down, Naruto Uzumaki.
Shut up! If you say a ninja hadn't put that monster in Gaara, none of this would have happened! Did you ever consider what Gaara thought? Did you ever even ask? You call him a Jinchuriki? Who are you to decide that fate for someone else?
Naruto wailed in grief. Moved by this display, Granny Chiyo, a prominent figure in the Hidden Sand, gave her own life to bring Gaara back from the dead. She did this because of her faith in the ability of the young to change the future.
Naruto, Lady Chiyo entrusted the future to you and Gaara. It was a death befitting a ninja.
Yeah, same as the old man, the third Hokage.
Recalling that the third Hokage had held the same sentiments, Naruto resolved to carry that hope forward. With the information regarding Orochimaru that he had obtained during his fight with the Akatsuki, he set out for their hideout with his friends and Sai, a new member of Team Kakashi. There, Naruto was met by Sasuke, who had developed at an alarming rate under Orochimaru's training. For the first time since their clash in the Final Valley, the former teammates were reunited.
Sasuke, I found you!
I'm sick of you showing up all the time. Now I'll just cut you off completely.
I'm taking you home, no matter what!
You won't be able to put a scratch on me.
Why can't you understand? Sasuke! Sasuke! Sasuke!
Without so much as a nod in Naruto and Sakura's direction, Sasuke left with Orochimaru.
Sasuke!
I couldn't stop him again. I'm weak.
So that's the extent of your bond?
No, it isn't.
In that case, everything's fine. You can still bring Sasuke back.
Sai. Thanks. For real.
Lamenting his inability to stop them, Naruto vowed to become stronger. With painful memories of his failure at Orochimaru's hideout, he decided to train under Kakashi. At that same time, the Akatsuki's movements intensified, targeting Jinchuriki in various lands. Receiving reports that Akatsuki members had invaded the Land of Fire, the Hidden Leaf dispatched a strike team to stop their rampage. However, the team struggled in its fight against the all-but-immortal member of the Akatsuki, known as Kakazu. Having just completed training, Naruto rushed to their aid.
Naruto Uzumaki, I didn't think you'd come for me. You saved me some time.
I'll get you! Wind style, Rasen Shuriken! Hit it!
And so, Naruto bested a mighty foe who had once been considered unbeatable. Seeing this, Kakashi could see that the youth were ushering in the winds of change.
Naruto has become strong, truly strong. He's practically surpassed me. Can you sense it? You're always in his mind, inspiring him. You make him strong. You do know that. Don't you, Sasuke?